That is Miss Rodeo North Dakota, Danny Taylor. What do you say we give all three of those cowgirls a welcome here tonight?
Can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner it wave. Oh, the land of the free and the home of the brave.
So the 73 on his first round. Lamb needs to be in the 80s. In the 80s if he hopes to come back tomorrow for our U.S. Bank Championship Finals. 78, he'll be solid. Here goes. So watch the replay. You don't think it's dangerous to be a judge? Tucker Zane. Well, 61 on his first one, and 75 on his second. That's how we become one audience. Now it's going to agree with you. Well, one round one in round nine at the regular NFR, 295,000. It's KC Field. Just for right now, this guy doesn't have a peer. So they wanted to get his head up and stand a little more even. Here we go, Hillsboro, Texas. Too quiet out there. Come on. That's gonna hurt. Ready to do it again. Six-time national finalist. This will be his fourth horse today. Folks, that's a great Cornhusker cowboy. Let's let him hear us. Steven there. Battle injury. God.
got to be 83 points to make the top 12. It's going to be close.
Cody Cabral. Yeah, for those of you who drove all the way from home. Yeah, Monument, you probably don't want to hear it.
Excuse me, Cody. You were supposed to jump off.
Three-time national high school champ. We'll say you heard that. It's safe to say he tips his hat to the steer. The way cowboys tip their hats to bucket horses that buck them off.
I was like, hope he's not dating my girl.
Yeah. There was no tipping of the hat. You need to get your hands on some of those quarter horses with full train. Oh, you're going to have. Jake! You know what, folks? He didn't give up. You shouldn't either. Come on, look at that. Here we go, Kyle. Went from 15th to 7th in the world. Great. You know what he just did?
Quick,
you break that barrier. Ladies and gentlemen, let's hear it for the Mutton Buster. So we add the two together. No time on their first one, which means 4-7. They got to be fast, really fast.
Yowza!
Never got it. There it is, right there. What's your favorite genre of music?
Country.
Country. Oh. No time for Monty and Randall. Good work, Kale Markham, Buddy Hawkins. Out of five. Colorado and Colorado. Richard Dozier. Whoa! Pantyhose loop. They were 5'5". They're 6'4" tonight.
See, the ropes aren't tied to the saddle horn. They're not secured. You gotta play a Twister game. They were the champions of the Dayton National Championship Rodeo. Twister won Corpus. Steer went left. That was an unfriendly steer right there. Here's Wyoming and Colorado. Laramie to the horn, cursing to the feet. W. Wilson got the horn. Grab the toe. Another nice run. It's the National Western Stage Line. Driven by Mr. Scott Smith. Not only does he drive it, he trained the six black horses pulling it, and he built the stagecoach with his own two hands. That ought to deserve a round of applause. There should be more cameras flashing right now. More cameras flashing, because you don't get to see this very often. Stage Line was a very brief part of our nation's history. Do you realize, you look down there now, you're like, okay, you can fit 5 to 6 people in that stagecoach. Back in the day, they put it as many as 15 people in there. And hygiene in the 1880s, wasn't what it is today, I can tell you that. He's a former Citizen of the West Award recipient. He also currently serves on the National Western Stock Show Board of Directors. And oh, by the way, he's chairman of the board of Miller Coors. Everyone say hello to Mr. Pete Coors. There is a Colorado legend, folks. The guy bringing you that hitch is Jason Goodman from Fort Collins, Colorado. He calls it Percheron Thunder. The Touchstone Energy makes it possible for us to see those beautiful Percherons tonight. Folks, grandparents and grandparents had to do in order to build this great nation. 2,000 pounds apiece, 18 hands tall for each one of them, and they are a sight to see and behold. Let's say thanks to Jason Goodman for not throwing them away, keeping them a part of his life as well. Thank you, Cowboy. Appreciate you. Awesome play, Elliott with an 82. Reynolds was 80 on his first horse. Missed him out of the buckets. Tied for the lead on two with 164. He has to be 84 to take the lead. Derby championship. This guy's already made it back in the bareback riding. He could easily make it back in this. Over the rest of Full House. Might be another one right here. Cole Elshier. Three-time NFR 105. Until they find out it's Monopoly.
Look at this guy right here. $1 million. This is fake.
Casey Longbreak. Little Bunker. Rodeo Houston's little bucker for Casey Longbreak.
I don't know, sir. Swear.
Here we go. Hello, Dallas. Bye-bye, Dustin. The A song.
Come on now.
Here's Ryan. People. escape the deal. All right, everybody, help him, help him.
Okay.
10 points higher than that on this horse. Mullen, Nebraska. Here we go. Yeah. 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 Oh, he could be the all-around champion. Heard this rodeo since 1954. They're proud to present what has been called the finest precision mounted drill anywhere. Welcome them as they present the Ride of the Colors. Pride of their country, pride of their state, have long, long been trademarks for the Western Air Drills. Now the all-girl turning team enters. They ride at a precision unequaled at their speed. Their colorful costumes highlight their precision and skill. The team comes down the center of columns of fours. The columns split, and the flames dash through. Now, the team turns back into two pinwheels. They'll come out of these in columns of fours that'll split into pairs. This is called threading the needle in pairs. Watch the speed and the precision. It is a hallmark of the Western Air Drills. Very well done. Again, they come down the center, columns of fours. Watch this, they're gonna turn it into a propeller. The goal here is to keep the line straight and the speed high. Very well done. Now the flank points join in and it becomes a giant propeller. Come on, y'all, 39 men and women on horseback down there. Very nicely done. Propeller breaks down, and it will form two tandem wheels at the east and the west ends. Both of those wheels spinning in a clockwise direction. Now they start to pair off, break off. This is called the Mariner's Cross, as riders from each corner of the arena are heading to the center at the same time. When your timing isn't perfect, you end up crashing into a friend, so. Perfect time is required. Mariner's Cross done wonderfully. Wonderfully. This is called the Starburst, and it highlights the flames as the line turn around the points and sweep back into the center to form a four-point stop. Thank you. Now every rider joins in, and it becomes a giant stop. Check that out. You know, one of the most difficult things they'll do in this whole drill is something we call reversing the star arms. Because the outside horses have to go from a dead run to a dead stop. The inside horses have to go from barely moving to a dead run. And every horse and rider has to change speed and direction in order to reverse those star arms. Come on, people, you gotta agree, that's good work. That's good work. We're going to spread them out in one big circle. We're going to look for our Pied Piper. And it happens to be Remy. She's riding a nice bay horse called Radar. And we're going to start by going in a counterclockwise direction. Okay. This is called the corkscrew. You know what it looks like. There are big circles at the top, medium-sized circles in the middle, and tiny circles on the way down to the tip. So Remy is starting at the top of the corkscrew, and she is starting to head down that corkscrew. And with each circle getting progressively smaller than the circle before it, you'll notice that the speed seems like it's getting even faster, because the smaller the circle, the less room for air. Well, then you wonder, what is she gonna do when she gets to the tip? Ah, she's got this figured out. From the left lead to her right lead, from counterclockwise to clockwise, Remy will simply unwind the corkscrew. Come on, y'all, that's a nice drill right there. They've never quit running since they got in the arena. 1,000 youngsters compete, or participate, I should say, staffed entirely by volunteers. Watch them form a single file circle in the center of the arena right now. See that single file circle? There they go. Pretty quick, that circle's gonna break down into two lines. One heads south, the other heads north, they both head east. At the east end, the north line goes south, the south line goes north, and then I beg you, watch this. And ask yourself if they were off a half second, a half a stride, what would happen? Look how tight, look how close. One horse right after the other. Stitch after stitch. That's why they call it threading the needle. There's no room for error. They've done it perfectly again tonight. You know what, folks? The young people of today face an increasingly complex and confused world. And only through teamwork and cooperation can our nation hope to move forward in a positive direction. But the good news is, these are the skills that the riders and the Westerners have developed as they demonstrated in this ride. They developed teamwork, dedication, working for a cause greater than oneself. And so as we will all acknowledge, and now, ladies and gentlemen, the only applause that ever matters is what comes from you with the final Ride of the Colors. This amazing youth group from Jefferson, Colorado, under the direction of Glenn Keller, will pass in review. Let's hear it for the Westerners. So he's going to want to be in the sevens. Sevens would be good. Here's Reese.
Hey, hurry.
Yeah! Come on, folks, don't hold back. Oh, broke the barrier. Chase Williams, Stephenville, Texas. Great team roper, great calf roper. Not one of this first one. Come on, do that and more. There you go. He will be one of the top three cowboys coming back tomorrow. 7.7. He was 8-1 on his first run. 16-3 is one of the aggregate on two head. And a two-time national finalist, he's finally got his good horse back. He had to compete for the last couple of years with horses that weren't what he needed. Ah. Come on, Corey! He'll be back tomorrow in the top four. Corey Solomon, second in the round. 9-4 in his first run. This looks good too. 7. Puts him 8. That's the beauty of being in the last set of guys that go. You know exactly what you got to do just to break into the top 12. Speaking of breaking. Simple pleasures, man. Look, if you can't make yourself happy, who's gonna? Tyson. Out of no time on his first run, so. 8-4. He's in great shape. 7-9, he'd tie for the lead. We've already seen sevens, we know it's possible.
Appreciate it. E.J. Panetta, Sheridan in Wyoming. 10-5 to all. He's just going to call on the arena crew, it looks like.
Let's meet the three men
who'll be fighting bulls for the title. First, a 26-year-old from Eaton, Colorado.
A two-time champion of the Bulls of the Beach competition. This is Dustin Coney.
World champion, the reserve champion at Salinas. This is Weston Rutowski. He's a rancher and climbs cell phone towers. He's the youngest bullfighter here at 23 years of age. From Norfolk, Nebraska, this is Bo Shoot. Coney, Eaton, Colorado.
World champion, won in 2013.
So, there goes Weston. Come on, he wants you to clap your hands.
There's the 40-second whistle. He can sell it at any time. Yes, folks, give him a little more. Whoa, shoot.
It all comes down to the verdict. All comes down to the verdict from Haskell, Texas. 26-year-old Weston Rutowski going to take on the Buckle Ringer champion in our American bullfighting. Presented by Transwest Drugs and Cimarron Trailers. Thank you, Weston, this afternoon. Those who want to be 1540 or faster. Or faster.
Come on!
What are you doing? What are you standing, cowgirl? Let's go.
$20.69.
Here she goes.
Smooth. Barrel racing's turning into a demolition derby. Back to barrel this afternoon.
Wow. Nice.
Clean run. 15-8.
Ariana. 1589 on the first run.
Thank you.
winner of the National Western.
Cowboy's life is the life for me.